As agroflorestas afetam o clima.
L'adozione di buone pratiche culturali limita fenomeni di erosione.
Grass trees, they grow pretty much everywhere, so let's use them more.
PhD and MSc studies on the farm, which have shown increased levels of biodiversity, increased levels of spatial diversity of insects. One of the positive aspects of agroforestry is we're mixing perennial crops with annual crops.
Eu acredito que a agrofloresta tenha papel muito importante na agricultura do futuro.
As agroflorestas afetam o clima por várias razões, não só pelo carbono que sequestram, pelos níveis de carbono, mas essencialmente porque elas são a única estrutura neste planeta que consegue absorver, sem outro tipo de consequências, a energia do sol, que é muita.
Often people look at the system, the agroforestry system we've got, and they think we're taking land out of production into trees. I would say it's the reverse. We're actually trying to make the farm more intensive, and we're doing that by trying to capture more carbon and actually use more of the soil below the surface and more of the space above the ground and try and be more productive.
Ja, ik ben landbouwer, maar landbouwer op de late leeftijd. Ik heb de boerderij van mijn schoonouders overgenomen als hij met pensioen ging, en zo ben ik nu al 20 jaar boer. En ik ben tamelijk vroeg begonnen met agroforesterie en onder andere noten. Ik wist niet dat dat agroforesterie was.
Eu comecei a fazer agrofloresta de uma maneira completamente inconsciente e só me apercebi que fazíamos agrofloresta quando fui visitado por umas pessoas estrangeiras que trabalhavam para a Comissão Europeia e que ficaram muito surpreendidas quando aqui chegaram e me falaram em agrofloresta, porque eu, para mim é o sistema natural aqui da nossa região. E, portanto, não houve uma ação deliberada de fazer uma agrofloresta ou de implantar uma agrofloresta, porque ela já existia e portanto, era o sistema que eu sempre conheci.
Having had some exposure to agroforestry when I was working in Africa many years ago, we started to think how we might be able to apply that to a UK context. And it ticked many of the boxes that we were looking to try and achieve in terms of increasing productivity, increasing biodiversity, protecting the soil from wind erosion and fitting around our sort of arable farming system.
Waarom ik begonnen ben met agroforestry, ja, is omwille van de voordelen dat je een extra product kan telen gemengd met je akkerbouw eronder. Extra biodiversiteit, dat je gratis bladval hebt, dat er dus organische stof bij komt. En vooral, wij zitten in een heel winderige streek in de open polders aan de kust. En daarom wil ik zeker ook van de winter nog extra bomen aanplanten om die wind een beetje meer te breken. Daar hebben die bomen voordeel bij, maar ook gewoon de groenten.
Ja, dus omdat je meer insecten aantrekt en meer vogels aantrekt, krijg je meer een evenwicht. Natuurlijk, dat is nog, omdat mijn aanplant ook nog overwegend jong is, moet dat eigenlijk nog een beetje beginnen, maar ik geloof daar wel in. Ik geloof wel dat dat zal gebeuren, ja.
What we have seen is a massive change in biodiversity. There's been a number of studies, PhD and MSc studies on the farm, which have shown increased levels of biodiversity, increased levels of spatial diversity of insects. And you know, to us, pollinators are hugely important, and increasing the number of pollinators and increasing habitat for them, I think is hugely important for agriculture.
De andere insecten, ziektes, plagen in een boomgaard en zeker in onbehandelde bomen, daar krijg je toch vrij makkelijk, vrij goed een ecologisch evenwicht. Zodanig dat je zonder veel ingrijpen, zonder veel gebruik te maken van pesticiden, toch een zeker evenwicht hebt en waardoor dat dus het aantal vruchten dat beschadigd wordt door ziektes, door plagen, relatief beperkt is.
E tra l'altro, diciamo, con le loro deiezioni arricchiscono, anche se non in maniera, diciamo, sufficiente a mantenere la fertilità del suolo, va comunque integrata, però è un'integrazione, non è una fertilizzazione a tutto tondo degli oliveti aziendali. Quindi queste sono le prime due cose. E poi anche ci metterei, tenendo gli olivi più alti, evitando gli stagni idrici tipici nelle zone basse di olivo, che sono un problema culturale non da poco. Quindi riesci anche a evitare dei trattamenti fitoiatrici. Per esempio il rame si può dare meno, perché già le pecore te li tengono belli arieggiati e sollevati da terra.
In agrofloresta non sono necessarie as muletas todas che noi necessitiamo per produrre oggi in dia in scenari completamente desertificati, e erudidos que nós próprios humanos criamos.
So after 5 years of soil erosion, I decided the best thing to have on the ground is grass. It grows easily and it does stop soil erosion.
Et l'agroforesterie est un des systèmes qui permet ça, qui permet peut-être d'augmenter, de protéger les sols, d'augmenter les taux de matière organique, de faire un petit peu d'ombrage, de réguler l'eau, etc. En fait, et je crois beaucoup en ces systèmes-là, en fait, tout simplement pour continuer à produire un petit peu sur ces coteaux. Voilà. Il y avait aussi comme raison l'érosion, parce que là, c'est toujours pareil, c'est des coteaux, donc c'est très érosif, en fait. Et chaque ligne d'arbre, si elle est plantée en travers de la pente, suivant les courbes de niveau, ben forcément, elle crée une barrière mécanique, en fait, à l'eau et donc au sol, et donc au sol. Là aussi, ça a été un des moteurs, c'est l'érosion en fait, par rapport à l'implantation de ces bandes enherbées avec des arbres dessus. Quoi.
Senz'altro dal punto di vista ambientale, perché noi non, per esempio, non trattiamo, non concimiamo, e poi anche benefici, diciamo, economici, in quanto lo stesso terreno, trattandosi di azienda piccola, produce e dalla pianta e dal suolo. Quindi economicamente sta.
Ik heb altijd een voorliefde gehad voor bomen. Een bepaald moment las ik dan over het systeem in magazines en publicaties. En ik vond dat er wel iets in zat in dat systeem. En dat het een meerwaarde had op meerdere vlakken. Niet alleen de rendabiliteit, maar ook qua dat het meer natuurlijk was. Meer aansloot bij natuurlijke systemen op de planeet. En daarom heb ik het uiteindelijk toch gedaan.
Ja, goed nadenken over het plan hoe je het wil aanpakken, de plantafstanden en richtingen, de richting van de bomenrijen. Bij ons kwam dat eigenlijk gewoon goed uit dat dat noord-zuid gericht is op de meeste percelen. Ik bedoel dat de werkwijze, of hoe dat we het veld bewerken, sowieso al noord-zuid is. Op één plaats is het oost-west, maar daar heb ik dan gekozen voor die hazelaars en perziken die minder hoog worden en dus ook minder schaduw gaan geven in de toekomst.
For me, when I practice agroforestry, I'm trying to basically implement my observations of nature. So what I'm learning from the natural cycles, I'm trying to replicate. And especially here with mushrooms, we're not doing anything different than the natural forest ecosystem cycle, other than replacing with whatever would have colonized these logs with shiitake mycelium or reishi or whatever else we're growing. So in that way, agroforestry to me, it's closer to nature.
It copies the way that zebras or buffalo would roam around through prairies, grassland, woodlands in history. So we do that by putting them in a small enclosure. I've only got 5 sheep, but I can get an animal density that resembles a big group of wild animals.
Tudva lévő, hogy a ló és a vérkő nem ugyanazt eszi, tehát érdemes, ha nem is egy időben, tehát én ugyan egyszer a lovakat engedem rá utána a birkákat, tehát a ló más fűfélet eszik, a birka megint más, és a kecske meg a bokrokat. Tehát én mindenkinek azt javasolnám, ha teheti kecske, birka minimum, ha van módja, akkor ló is. És akkor nagyjából megvan a takarás, de, amit az előbb mondtam, hogy a gyom mellé kell a gép, mert kell a gép, azt kikerülje az állat, és ezzel együtt, tehát géppel, lóval, pirkával és kecskével talán megnyerjük a meccset.
Los recursos que emplego para el meu gado son baseados na natureza. Somos autosuficientes, o sea que no mercamos nada de afuera, Alimentación do gado de castiñeiros, por exemplo, aproveitamos os follatos, aproveitamos agora, desde que se acaba a colleita da castaña, as castañas, o líquen dos árboles, a folla, os follatos dos rebolos, e aparte deso, agora nesta época que normalmente está todo axeadado, pois sementamos centeo, pásteno as ovellas, hasta dia 20 de janeiro, máis ou menos.
Dlaczego warto sadzić drzewa na pastwiskach? Mamy dodatkową produkcję drzewną, mamy dodatkową produkcję paszową, tak jak tutaj mamy ulęgałkę, która produkuje nawet do kilkuset kilogramów małych gruszeczek, które stanowią bardzo dobre uzupełnienie paszy dla bydła.
With mob grazing into the woodland, it was purely by accident. It's a hot sunny day today. I try to make sure that there is some shade available to the sheep. So if they're out in the field, then I try to, you know, give them something that's got some shade. And it seemed natural to kind of jump into the woods a little bit just to give them some natural shade. And yeah, they started eating into the undergrowth. So it happened quite by accident. But effectively, it gives me more land to use. And they seem to enjoy it. They eat all the leaves off the trees. It's kind of where I've used this kind of technique, it's changing the way that the farm looks.
Os sistemas agroforestais en Galicia son absolutamente esenciais de cara fundamentalmente a prevención de incendios e a permitir despois un mellor control. E sobre todo son tamén unha parte esencial na economía agraria, porque ten sinerxias entre o sector gandeiro, sobre todo extensivo, e o sector forestal, complementanse mutuamente e ademais sobre todo defendense mutuamente.
Zadrzewienia tego typu dają bydłu w lecie ochronę przed słońcem oraz pełnią funkcję produkcyjną, produkcję drewna opałowego. A na wiosnę można także pozyskać tutaj bardzo dobrej jakości sok brzozowy.
A chuva, a precipitação está diretamente relacionada com a dinâmica do que nós temos no solo e com as florestas.
One of the attractions for me for agroforestry is that, you know, typically we only think of our crop production about a meter above ground at most, and probably half a meter below ground, whereas the trees in the system are using more space. So we're trying to capture sunlight for a longer period during the season, and also using more space above and below the ground to actually grow crops. So it's sort of vertical or tiered farming systems. The beauty for us is that the wheat that you can see behind you is capturing its sunlight and nutrients early in the season and turning those into carbon and into cash crop. And then later in the season, when the cereals are actually dying off, the apple trees are still capturing that sunlight and turning it into a crop right through to the late autumn. So we move seamlessly on this farm from cereal harvest in midsummer through to fruit harvest in late autumn.
As nossas grandes dificuldades aqui no Mediterrâneo para aplicarmos os bons princípios de uma agricultura de conservação passam pela gestão que nós fazemos durante o período seco, o nosso verão e hoje em dia o nosso outono. E portanto, sempre que olhamos para sistemas diferentes, eles muitas vezes não nos respondem a essa pergunta em concreto de como é que nós devemos fazer essa gestão. Mas eu, curiosamente, no meu caso, tenho aprendido muito com produtores estrangeiros e através do Afinet tenho... Às vezes são pequenos exemplos que nos fazem umas cócegas no cérebro e que nos põem a pensar de que forma é que nós conseguimos aplicar aquele princípio na nossa realidade.
Dias como hoje são ótimos, estes workshops, onde trazemos pessoas juntos. Todo mundo tem um espaço para falar sobre as suas ideias e o que estão fazendo. E, you know, eles aprendem de nós e nós aprendemos de eles. É such a beautiful thing, and I'm really happy that Afinet supports this kind of thing. It's really incredible to bring everyone together and just talk about what's going on. What are the ways of work? What are the things that are... How can we help each other?
Un confronto, una conoscenza di vari attori che comunque confluiscono in questo settore, quindi penso che sia importante.
Wel, als je begint met bomen, je hebt nog nooit bomen geplant, heb je eigenlijk in het begin een beetje gebrek aan kennis. En ook omdat je al vrij snel, ik dan toch vrij snel bezig was met verschillende soorten bomen. Het was dus in het begin eiken, maar daarna ben ik overgegaan op fruitbomen, notelaars enzovoort. Dan moet je wel heel veel kennis hebben om al die verschillende bomen goed te beheren, te snoeien. Maar ook de aanplant kan al verschillend zijn. En ook de verschillende rassen. Moet je allemaal een beetje kennis van hebben. En vaak heb je in het begin toch wel wat gebrek aan kennis en ervaring. En weet je ook niet altijd direct waar je terecht kunt. Dus dat was eigenlijk wel een aanvankelijk een beetje een probleem.
Não há comida. E para termos comida, nós temos que ter uma comida baseada em modelos consentâneos com o funcionamento do sistema terrestre e uma parte das pessoas que pensam nisto em profundidade chegam à conclusão que sem agrofloresta nós poderíamos habitar este planeta num número muito inferior ao que poderíamos ter em agrofloresta. Não é?
O grande argumento para eu conseguir vender os meus produtos será a maneira amiga do ambiente como eu os produzo. E a agrofloresta permite isso, ou seja, permite abrir a exploração a quem quer que seja para ver e para ver como é que as coisas se produzem. E o grande argumento de venda para mim é de facto o nosso modelo de produção que se consegue com as agroflorestas.
Neste momento há uma coisa muito importante, que é termos o conhecimento, começamos a alicerçar o conhecimento que nos permite dar passos certeiros e inequívocos nessa construção.
Não é? I think there's a lot of work to do and there's a lot of research and kind of experimenting, but I just see that every aspect of it seems to be positive in some way. I can't really find any faults with it. It's better for the animals, it's better for the soil, better for the woodland, it's better for me. You know? It's that kind of thing.